Hello, happy and smart developers. Welcome to the coding board. This is series of internet and this is part 9. So let's begin this session. In last session, we have learned that the internet is completely open. Any computer can connect with any computer and share information. Shared information is in plain text. This makes it possible for hackers to snoop on any personal information that you send over the internet. It simply means that because internet is physical tangible system and it is completely open, hence hacker can attack on your computer. So this makes it possible for hackers to snoop on any personal information that you send over the internet. Today we are going to learn how to overcome these security related challenges. Now, please pay attention. Let's understand security. The challenge is shared information is in plain text. This makes it possible for hackers to snoop on any personal information that you send over the internet. To overcome this challenge, safe website prevent this by asking your web browser to communicate on secure channel using secure socket layer and its successor transport layer security. Let me help you to understand with one example. Suppose I have one bank account in SBI Bank and I am using online banking to do some transaction. So what I will do? I will simply use my web browser. I will type URL of SBI in URL bar. Then what SBI will do? SBI will ask my browser to please communicate on secure channel using socket layer, and its successor transport layer security. What is this? We will understand in depth. We think secure socket layer and transport layer security as a layer of security. We think secure socket layer and transport layer security that wrap around your communication to protect information from snooping and tampering. SSL and TLS, nothing but secure socket layer and its successor transport layer security are active when we see the little lock that appear in your browser address bar next to the HTTPS. What is that? You will understand with pictorial representation. This is the picture. See here, this is lock. Here is HTTPS. S means security. We know very well transmission control protocol, correct? Get request and post request. We have learned in last session, but this get request, post request should be secure. For that reason, we have SSL, socket security layer, and its successor transport layer security, which wrap our communication. And how we will understand that our communication is secure? If we find this lock, okay, on our browser, then it simply means that our communication is wrapped by these two legends, nothing but socket security layer and transport level security. I hope now you have better understanding. Let's move on. HTTPS, Hypertext Transport Protocol, HTTPS protocol ensures that your HTTP requests are secure and protected. When a website asks your browser to engage in a secure connection, it first provides a digital certificate. Let me explain this with one example. Suppose I am having bank account in SBI Bank. SBI has its online banking website. So what I will do? I will type URL in web browser and I will try to connect with SBI online banking website. This request will be get request. But what SBI website will do? SBI website will ask my browser to engage in secure connection. For that, what it will do? It will first show his certificate, digital certificate, to my browser. How it will show? A digital certificate is an official ID card proving that it is the website it claims to be. Let's understand about digital certificates. Digital certificates are published by certificate authorities, which are trusted entities that verifies and identifies websites and issues certificates for them. Let me repeat once again. Digital certificates are published by certificate authorities, which are trusted entities that verifies the identities of websites and issues certificate for them. It is similar like having license. In layman language, for example, I have bike, then I should have proper license, correct? So that traffic inspector will understand he has license, means he know how to drive bike safely. Similarly, digital certificates are published by certificate authorities, which are trusted entities. What they will do? They will verify the identities of website, means they will check this website is that website only or it is something else, and then only they will issue certificate for them. Now, certificate authorities are just like government who can issue identity card or passport. If website tries to start secure connection without properly issued digital certificate, your browser will warn you that this site security certificate is invalid or not trusted. This is the basics of web browsing. HTTP, Hypertext Transfer Protocol, and DNS, Domain Name System, manage the sending and receiving of HTML code, media files, or anything on the web. We have already learned Hypertext Transfer Protocol, HTTP GET Request, HTTP POST Request, and Domain Name System for having name, domain's name instead of their addresses. So HTTP and DNS manage the sending and receiving of HTML code, media files, or anything on the web. Already learned that in last session, information on the internet goes from one computer to another in what we call packet. Suppose user want to send image, then this image will get divided into hundreds or even thousands of separate parts called packets. TCP, Transmission Control Protocol. Transmission Control Protocol manages sending as well as receiving of all your data as packets. Okay. As part of the internet protocol, every router machine keeps track of multiple path for sending packets and it chooses the cheapest available path for each pieces of data based on destination IP address for the packet. These packets themselves are made up of binary sequence of zeros and ones that are physically sent through electricity, fiber optic cables and wireless networks. Now, HTTP and DNS, what they will do? They will manage sending and receiving HTML code or web files. TCP/IP transmission control protocol and routing, what they will do? They will break down and transport packets. Now, wires, cables and Wi-Fi, what they will do? They will physically transfer data from source to destination. So they are medium. All these layers work together to successively deliver information with reliability. We can trust that all those layers, HTTP and DNS, TCP/IP and routing, wires, cables and Wi-Fi will work together to send data from source to destination safely. That's it in this session. Let's meet in another session. Thank you.